All right, let's see what we got today in misleading news headlines. Your current net health may be the best predictor of generational wealth. Okay, all right. Net health. So, just add this. That looks good.
Dude, you see Doge today, man? It is going to the literal... What are you doing?
Oh, I was just calculating my net health.
And you get that in the fridge?
Yeah. You hungry? Yo, what is up? Welcome back to another week of How to Health. My name is Kevin. I run liftandbalance.com, where we take aim at all things health and do it in an odd, weird, interesting, and highly sarcastic manner. Today, we are tackling one of the common misconceptions that taking care of yourself, investing in your health, and living a healthy lifestyle is simply too expensive for the average you and me. In fact, I see it as such a misconception that I am going to walk you through here and today how a transition to a healthy lifestyle can not only save you some money, but also make you more, and even set you and your family up for a higher likelihood of generational wealth. How? By seeking generational health, of course. So let's break down this macro-micro view of the decision to own your shit, I mean health, will literally pay off during your lifetime and potentially generations to come. But before we dive in, let me first elaborate on what I mean by generational health. To explain this, let's first start off with the easier, more talked about concept of generational wealth. This is the idea that the wealth that one accumulates over their lifespan will be passed down to their family and loved ones when their time on this floating rock comes to an end. This transfer in assets will set their loved ones up for a more comfortable, secure financial future that, in a perfect world, which we know we don't live in, will be passed down for generations to come. Now, let's take this same concept and apply it to health. Generational health is the concept that the healthy lifestyle habits and values that you develop and instill within your family will establish a long lineage of healthy family to come. Just like I'm doing with my family, production team. Now I bet you're wondering, how do the two, generational wealth and generational health, relate? And how the hell do I get started? And all I gotta say is, I couldn't have asked a better question myself. First, let's start with the savings potential. By living a healthy lifestyle, you save on the cost of both healthcare and unhealthy habits. Healthcare is expensive, and it's only getting more expensive. And as you know from all of our other powwows, one of the most important factors for maximizing longevity or pushing those healthy years of life out as far as humanly possible is delaying disease onset. Slow-moving chronic diseases happen to be one of the most prevalent longevity liabilities that are plaguing modern society. The CDC, or Center for Disease Control, estimates that 6 out of 10 US adults are dealing with one chronic condition, and 4 out of 10 are dealing with two or more. Those are some pretty staggering numbers. And you want to know what's even more staggering? All of these chronic conditions have been identified as highly preventable. How? Through healthy lifestyle habits, by prioritizing sleep, eating more real and less processed, moving intentionally and methodically on a daily basis, and building a healthy, non-toxic environment to live in. All of which, might I add, we cover in depth on this channel. So where do the costs lie? First, the cost of a daily unhealthy habit like smoking or junk food can easily run you $10 a day, or over $3,500 a year. The cost of inactivity or being sedentary has been estimated to be between $650 and $1,100 per person per year. And let's not forget the cost of lost productivity, which in many cases is just simply too hard to quantify. all in all, let's go with a conservative estimate of $5,000 a year. And all while costing you extra moolah, these unhealthy habits work against the top longevity strategy that we all have, prevention, specifically of the aforementioned disease onset. And once disease states begin, the costs don't decrease. They do the opposite. For example, it's been estimated that delaying the onset of a common chronic condition like type 2 diabetes can save thousands of dollars annually in increased medical costs. And the CDC has even got in on the financial analysis themselves, estimating that a 10% weight loss can reduce an overweight person's lifetime medical costs from $2,200 to $5,300. So that right there provides a little glimpse of how all these costs can accumulate. But what about those not so obvious ones? Those sneaky hidden ones? Loss of productivity. By now, hopefully you've picked up the fact that this channel focuses on how we can put our body in the very best possible position to operate efficiently. And one of the sometimes harsh realizations that many people have to come to grips with on their journey is the simple concept. What you put in is what you get out.
This is the hardest thing I've ever had to do in my entire life.
Feeling good, refreshed, energized, cognitively capable each and every day doesn't just happen. In fact, the modern societal landscape stacks the odds against us in attaining this goal. But that doesn't mean your only choice is to roll over and assume fetal position, eating whatever BS society serves up that day. When we get shitty sleep, eat crappy food, don't move, and live with no regard about the chemical toxins riddled throughout the modern day environment, we put our body in a degraded physiological and biochemical state each and every day, making us tired, sore, lethargic, inflamed, with a side of cognitive impairment and brain fog. Try and convince me that you're gonna do your best work under these common conditions. I'll wait. Production team, you wanna play a game? No, we're not playing Bop It. We played yesterday. Yet, this is how the majority of people walk around, day in and day out. And research has indicated that poor health decreases productivity and makes workers less useful, which is directly correlated with lower work earnings, which then has you leaving even more potential wealth on the table. But how much potential wealth? Let's go through a little experiment. How compounding health equals compounding wealth. So quick recap. Thus far, by owning your health, you will do two key things. Reduce your expenses and increase your potential earnings. So let's look at how those two things play a role in wealth accumulation over the average life. Let's say you're 30 and you decide to start investing in your health. Good decision. These healthy habits reduce your health expenses and increase your earning potential to the point where you can save or earn an extra $5,000 a year. If you started with $0 and you put $400 a month into a conservative investment vehicle like a S&P 500 index fund, which returns 7% annually, by the time you're 60, you'd have over $450,000. At 70, over $950,000. And at 80, the average lifespan for the average person, although, you know, we know you're not average, you'd have almost $2 million. That, my friends, is the power of compounding interest. And in this case, it's driven by compounding health. Best of both worlds, if you ask me. The cool part is it works in a rather simple way. Healthy lifestyle habits increase the odds of longevity. And people who live longer have more times to grow their savings through the power of compounding interest. Pretty cool, right? So how does this turn into a generational thing? Let's get generational. I think it's pretty accepted that each and every one of us are influenced by the people that we grow up with or around. Picking up and learning how to do this thing called life from the people who seem like they have a pretty good idea of what's going on. Does anyone know what's going? No? Okay. And in most cases, but certainly not all, that's our family. Families tend to do things together, like wake up, eat, play, socialize, and hit the hay in some consistent way each and every day. And thus, a lot of the habits, routines, rituals get passed down from the older generations to the younger. This, as you can imagine, can be both good and bad. It all depends on one of our favorite words, context. So part of this generational health wealth strategy is education, developing and passing on the healthy habits that you've worked so hard to build to the people that you care about most, helping them discover and solidify their own values and hopefully building on the great, awesome, healthy foundation that you laid, thus making healthy living a core part of both you and their lives. And by promoting the value of health to the ones that you love and care about, you will be giving them potentially the greatest gift you can ever give them, an increased likelihood of a long, prosperous, happy, fulfilled life, one that they will hopefully pass on in a similar tradition. So with that, let's put the final pieces of the puzzle together. Hopefully you're not like production team and always lose the pieces of the puzzle. Do you have the puzzle? Secure your future by being the disruptor, by being the person who decided they were going to rebel against societal norms and own their shit. You've increased your personal wealth by saving on healthcare and unhealthy habit costs, increasing your productivity and earning potential, living longer and healthier, giving more time for that extra moolah to compound and grow, providing your loved ones with a much better financial position when your time on this floating rock is done. But even more importantly, setting them up with healthy lifestyle values on which they can grow and improve. Setting up your future generations with health, wealth, and prosperity. Seems like a pretty good deal to me. Where do I sign? And thus, generational wealth can most certainly be driven by generational health. And generational health starts with someone seeking to improve themselves. Their mind, their body, their spirit. And get the most out of these pretty cool meat suits as long as they embody them. There is simply no reason to destroy your health in the process of accumulating wealth. You can have them both. And as you just saw, they fit pretty nicely together. But just like anything else worthwhile in this world, it takes a little bit of work, ambition, and elbow grease. Own your health, own your outcome. And there's no better day, start investing. No, production team, do not buy Dogecoin. Have you been listening to any of this? That's not what I meant. Cut.